Well, we got this old baby here. It's time to get down to it. And we need to replace this bit of binding here. So it plays right. We're going to do new frets, but I'm a little scared about the binding because the right glue is becoming very difficult to find. So when we get to that point in the program, it's time to test things. Instead of trying to stick things together and failing, let's just go fail on something that doesn't matter. Does that make sense? You know, and as always, my bench looks like shit, but that's the way I like to roll. So look what I have. A piece of the elusive rosewood. And, you know, rosewood is stiff, hard stuff. Like many other woods, if I did that with the grain, that would just snap. Serious stuff. And this is my binding material. The glue that they promote, unfortunately, can't be shipped to Canada from USA. I'm pretty sure I know what it is, but then I did a little research, and what did we come up with? We came up with this, which is supposed to be pretty good. In Canada, it's LePage. In the USA, it would be Loctite. It's another thing I learned. And the child proof, of course, I can't get at it. Push and unscrew. Oh, fuck. Yeah, right. I'm pushing. And it ain't unscrewing. I'll be right back. Okay. So I'm by no means any way a fucking girly man, but this is fucked, right? Like, seriously? Okay. I'm not beat yet. Well, now that we solved that issue, Jesus fuck. Sorry for the bad language. It's just like, come on. Oh, look, it's probably all dried out in here, and this will be a total frickin' waste of time. You watch. This will be an $8 waste of time. Oh, no, look, it fucking pooped out. Oh, Christ. Well, if anything, it'll be of use to glue the cracks in my fingers closed. But I thought... See, it's the gel. That's nice. Really nice control. So that's going to be good. Let's just push that along. And that was probably way too much. But maybe not. Push that down. And we will use a piece of tape to hold it in place. Just like we would with the binding, and I'm going to come back in a while and see if I won. I'm a little disappointed about that stupid jar came in. Like, come on. Really? So what will happen if this doesn't work the way I'm hoping it will, I'm going to have to go up to the hobby shop and get some really nasty stuff. Hey, you see? Somebody likes me. Get some nasty stuff and do a couple other tests with that. And then there's the old weld bun, but you can't get that at a store. You got to go to an industrial place that sells things for making stuff out of plastic. Lucky for me, I made things out of plastic for a long time in the movies. So this will get solved, but it's what it is. It's just all anything solvent based is so pain in the ass to ship for anybody. So what happens is if you live in America and these products are made in America, well, you're in. But everybody else is boxed out. you know, add 30% for the hazardous goods shipping and all that. It's just become no fun. Can't use things that stink or hurt the environment. It's over. So we need to move on. That's why I'm testing. Okay, so this will be the test. If I yank that piece of binding off there and there's wood stuck to it, I've won. If not, it's a gooch. If there's just a bunch of glue stuck to one thing and not to the other. And look at that, folks. I think we got ourselves a winner. That's it. And it etches itself right into that plastic. Nice! That's solved. Okay. Tomorrow, take a deep breath, pucker up. And I'm going to get that old Gibson on the bench, and we're going to get the frets off it and replace that piece of missing binding, bang some new frets in it, put a new nut on it, and make it go again, hopefully for another 60 years. I'm amazed. There's a reason there's no old acoustic guitars. We'll talk. Cheers.